My name is Vito Scaletta. I was born in Sicily in 1925. That little guy's me. I'm standing there with my parents and my sister Francesca in front of our old house. I don't really remember too much about the old country, except that we were pretty hard up. And then one day my father decided it was time to move away. Away from Sicily, across the ocean, to start a new life in America. Seen anything as fantastic as Empire Bay. It was beautiful. On the other hand, I'd never seen anything filthier, more disgusting than our new shithole of an apartment. The American dream. It was more like a nightmare. My father started working at the port for the guy who arranged our immigration. It was backbreaking work, and what little money he made mostly went towards booze. Eventually, my parents sent me to school. I had to learn English. I sure as hell wasn't gonna do that in a neighborhood full of Italians. That's where I met Joe.
Come on, Vito, hurry it up. We ain't got all night.
Over time, Joe and I got to be best friends. And since we were both poor and there wasn't much work around, shit, we started a little business of our own.
Freeze! Police! Stop!
Vito, this way! Throw me to bed!
Stop! I'm gonna shoot!
Shit.
Okay, you bastard. Spread your legs.
Fuck.
And put your hands on the fence.
I'm sorry.
Well, that one time it didn't work out so good. The year was 1943. America was at war, and the army was looking for guys who spoke the language to help with the invasion of Sicily. I was 18, and anything seemed better than jail. Who says you can't go home again?
Operation Husky. I was assigned to the 504th Parachute Infantry. On the 11th of July, we were supposed to be dropped over the southern coast of Sicily, but we got hit by flak and had to bail out, way behind enemy lines. Only three of us made it. If it wasn't for the local resistance, we wouldn't have had a chance. So when Mussolini soldiers came into the town and started rounding everybody up, we decided to return the favor.
Se nessuno parla, quest'uomo morirà.
No.
All right, Scaletta, take the shot.
Allora, traditori, pensavate di poterci prendere in giro? Di tradirci? Avete pensato male?
What the hell
vi
are you
facciamo
waiting
vedere
for?
Noi
take
come trattiamo i traditori. Gli altri c'è nella resistenza.
They're falling back. Let's move.
On me.
Get up here, Scaletta. Shit.
I'm dead. Shit.
You and Williams take out that machine gun nest. Then find the prisoners. We're gonna need every man we can get.
Ain't getting through this way.
Looks like we found them again.
Scaletta, this would be a great fucking time to use it! Put a grenade to the window!
Galena, you alive?
Yeah, just about.
Well, then get off your ass and let's move.
Grab all the ammo you can carry. This might be our last chance.
Prisoners upstairs.
Clear the second floor. Scaletta, you take point.
Uccidete gli ostaggi!
Got him.
The door, Scaletta! Kick it in!
Arrenditi, o gli faccio saltare il sacco!
Shit. Looks like we're going this way. Come on.
Oh, shit! See, he's about to burn you!
This is a fucking skip shot!
Shoot!
Hey, mind by me, asshole!
Shit! This balcony is in the
room! I'm
trying to keep moving!
Get inside! Get inside, Scaletta! There's a guy up there!
Avutri fascisti! Arrivano avutri fascisti! Puttano un bossi!
See that gun on the balcony, Scaletta? Get on it! Let's go! Get on that machine gun! If these guys get inside, we're fucked! Take out that truck!
Dicevo al mio amico di stare attento.
Fregatene di fare attenzione, fai ciò che ti è stato detto!
Ho sparato, Becciotti!
Ma che diavolo sta dicendo? Chi si crede di essere?
Un offerto da fare!
Ma è davvero Don Calò?
Questo è finito!
Cacetto! Un congè quando siamo arretati come cucina.
Ma chi è quello? Lo conoscete?
Lo conoscono tutti. Don Calò è un uomo d'onore.
È uno stupido trucco degli americani, non ditemi che gli credete.
No, è davvero Don Calò. Ogni tanto dovreste ascoltare i consigli di noi altri del posto. Ci rendiamo.
Sapete che potete fidarvi di me. Che ne dite, eh?
Don Calò, the head of the Sicilian Mafia. An entire garrison of troops surrendered that day. Why? because he told them to. A few years later, the Nazis put a bullet in me. I was in the hospital for a bit, and then I got a month's leave so I could go home. At least for a little while.
Vito! Over here!
Joe!
Hey! Welcome home, buddy.
How'd you know?
I got my sources. Come on, let's take a ride.
Nice car.
Comes with the territory. I know you're itching to get home, but first, let's get a beer.
Yeah, sure.
There it is. Empire Bay. Tell the truth, you miss it?
Hey, there's a bear shit in the woods. Not like this place ever done me any favors, but anything's better than a foxhole. What's with this shitty weather?
They're saying this is the coldest winter on record. Papers say it's gonna keep up like this for weeks. Don't worry, though. A drink will warm you right up. How long's it been since we had a drink together, Vito? 2 years?
Almost three. Tony Sicilian's party, right?
Come on, Vito. Come on. The last drink we had together was right after your romance funeral. Right before you shipped out. You remember.
5 minutes. We're already talking about my deadbeat father. Can we change the subject, please?
So tell me, pal. What was it like over there anyway? I kept reading the papers to see what was going on. And you know how much I hate reading.
Yeah, I know.
You guys kicked Mussolini's ass, right?
Sort of. We had a little help from a guy named Don Calò.
No shit. Don Calò. I heard of him.
Really?
You bet. I know guys like him over here. Wise guys. You work for them, you're set. You fuck with them, you die.
Nice to see you've been busy.
Yeah, and I heard you got a medal, right?
From old man Patton himself.
Whoa, so you're a real war hero, huh? And then what? You screwed a couple of Sicilian broads and came home?
Yeah, right.
The old country. Over here, you can screw anything with a heartbeat. No one gives a shit. What a country. Here's to the US of A and to having you back home.
Salud.
A salud, chin down. So how come you're back? They let you out early for good behavior?
I took a bullet a couple months back, spent some time in the hospital, and now I'm on leave.
Wait, you mean you gotta go back?
What'd you think? The war ain't over yet.
You don't want to go back, do you?
Of course not, but what can I do?
1 minute. Wait right here.
Both mother and daughter working for the Yankee dollar.
Hey, Giuseppe, it's Joe. Remember last week, you know, the guy's name is Vito Scaletta. Thanks, Giuseppe. All right, I'll see you later. Okay, listen up. It appears that your injury is much more serious than it first appeared, and the doctors say you can't fight no more.
What? Whoa. Did you just...
Like I said, I know people. You get all the official paperwork tomorrow. When it comes to the right stamps and signatures, it's just a question of money.
You're kidding me, right? Isn't that a bit risky? It's me that could end up in a slammer, you know? And how am I gonna pay for it?
I got it covered. Think of it as a welcome home present. And don't worry, the documents will be clean. Trust me.
Well, thanks.
You're welcome. Como no frade, you're like a brother to me. Now you can start thinking about what you're gonna do next.
Sure. But first, I gotta go home.
All right, you wanna ride?
No, thanks. I wanna walk around a little, see what's changed since I've been gone.
No problem. Say hello to your sister for me. Come see me tomorrow. We got a lot to talk about.
I can't believe you just got me out of the service. Thanks again.
No problem.
I'll catch up with you tomorrow.
Here we are.
All right, thanks. Keep the change.
The fire is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Man, it doesn't show signs of stopping. And I brought me some...
Hey, Vito, look who's back. You're looking pretty good for a guy who just got shot.
Hey, Lisa, how you doing?
Francesca said you were coming back. Finally, some good news, eh?
Yeah, no kidding. It's good to be back.
You know, I'm real glad you're all right. Neighborhood just wasn't the same without you.
Well, everything still looks the same around here, including you. So, what are you doing?
You know, the usual, cooking dinner for Tony and the kids.
Oh, you got married? Boy, you didn't waste any time, huh?
Come on, Vito. I'm 21 years old here. Of course I'm married with two kids. Yeah, well, it was real good seeing you. Say hello to your mother for me, will you?
But you are when looking home. Finally you are not going to find me dead.
I'll be going out in the storm. But if you really grab me tight, all the way home I'll be warm. Oh, the fire is slowly dying. And my dear, we're still goodbye. But as long as you love me so, let it snow. Let it snow.
Hey, what's the good word?
How you doing, soldier?
A lot better now that I'm home.
You on leave or home for good?
That's, classified. So, what's new around here?
Tell the truth, not much. Everybody just wants the war to be over. And they're saying this is the coldest winter on record. I wish I had some good news for you.
Yeah, you and me both. All right, I'll see you.
Catch you later, buddy.
Is that you?
Hello, Mrs.
Vito? It is you. You look so handsome in that uniform. Your mother must be so proud. And what about poor Salvatore Montemaggiore? How's he doing? His poor mother was expecting him home a week ago.
Yeah, Sal joined the Navy. I'm in the Army. Different.
Why don't you come inside and have some tea with me, Vito? You could tell me all about it.
Thanks, but I'm kind of in a hurry. I just got back, and I can't wait to see my mother and Frankie.
Such a pretty girl, that Francesca. It's a wonder she's not married yet. Well, say hello to your mother for me, Vito.
One lousy beer!
Crazy broad.
That's what he said the last time. Then he comes home at 3 a.m. smelling like gin and another dame's perfume.
Hey, George, come on. You don't gotta listen to everything the old lady says, do you?
George isn't going to
Look, those are ours.
Of course they're ours.
Yeah, that's what everybody said when the Japs attacked Pearl Harbor. We got that in mind.
See the stars and stripes?
Yeah, hey, soldier,
no one's shooting, but I hope you need something.
Vito? Is that you?
Hey, Mr. Manar. You closing the shop?
Yeah, you know how it is. Can't afford to stay in business, though.
Wow, I'm sorry.
Yeah, well, the war's not your fault, Vito. Who knows? Maybe when the war ends, I'll open up again.
Well, good luck, then.
Hey, thanks, kid.
How can I help you today? I think you'll find the quality is well worth the price.
The stars belong to everyone. They gleam there for you and me. The flowers in spring, the robins that sing, the sunbeams that shine, they're yours, they're mine, and belong to everyone.
Take care.
What's up, man?
You're in my way. Out of my way.
I should go home. I haven't seen Mama and Francesca forever.
What I can do for you, soldier?
Hi, Mama. I'm back.
Vito. Vito, my boy. My boy's home. I thought I'd never see you again. Francesca and me, we wait.
Hey, sis, what's going on?
We wait for you.
Yeah.
So sit down. You must be hungry, Vito. Francesca made you a special dinner. Zuppa di pollo. It's good for you.
Wow, looks good, Frankie.
It's a shame your papa didn't live to see this. He would be so proud, Vito.
Yeah, sure.
Vito, you know better.
Sorry, Mama, sorry.
Benedice, Signore, la manciata, per la tua volontà. Stiamo ricevendo, providene al puro cucino di un'altra.
You should get some sleep. Your room is just like you left it.
So how you two been? Franny, what you been up to?
I still live here with Mama. I got a nice office job. It pays the bills, and I started paying off some of Papa's debts.
Francesca, we don't want to talk about that now.
So, you got a boyfriend yet?
Not yet.
What's that? The boys in the neighborhood these days are not so good. She'll meet the right man one day. How are you, mio bandino? It must have been so terrible. I was so afraid. I prayed for you every day.
I'm okay, Ma. I drove a Jeep most of the time. Sometimes I had a fight. I'll see you 2 in the morning.
Sleep well, mio bambino.
This ain't gonna cut it. I gotta find a place to stay.
So you have to go back soon?
Actually, looks like I won't. Joe's taking care of it for me.
Joe! You want to get into trouble again?
Mama, would you rather me go back and get shot again?
No.
Exactly.
No.
Joe probably saved my life.
Promise that you won't get in any more trouble with that, Joe. You know, your papa used to work for this man at the waterfront named Pappalardo. He's in the union. You could talk to him, work hard like you were your papa. Talk to him. Please, promise me you go talk to him today.
Okay, Mama, okay, I promise.
Grazie, Leo.
I don't give
I'm
a
sorry.
Damn. I don't care
we'll get
if you gotta
money.
Sell everything
hey,
you got.
What the hell's going on here?
Vito!
You mind your business,
no.
asshole.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Come on, Junior. I'm gonna take you to school.
Oh, tough guy. Scaring a woman, huh? Come on. Show me what you got.
Vito, please. You're making it even worse. Stop, stop, please! Vito, what are you doing? Please, Vito, this isn't a problem.
Yeah, that's right. Get the fuck out of here.
You're gonna be sorry. The both of yous.
What the hell was that all about?
I'm sorry, Vito. We didn't want to bother you with this.
Bother me? Bother me with what? Come on, tell me what's going on here, Frankie.
Right before he died, Papa borrowed money. A lot of money from a loan shark. Thinking he'd get a better job and pay him back. We found out right after you left for the war.
How much?
$2,000.
What? Shit.
The worst thing is, this guy wants it all back by the end of this week. Otherwise, the debt goes up again.
I ain't gonna make that kind of money working at the port. Who is this guy?
I don't know. Mama won't tell me. It's okay, Vito. We'll manage somehow.
Don't worry. I'll take care of this. I promise.
Thanks, Vito. Take care of yourself.
I gotta get my hands on $2,000 fast. I bet Joe could help me out.
My way.
Brawling in the street. 10-4. I got a runner. I'm taking him in.
Roger that.
Suspect is about 6 feet tall. Copy that. In pursuit of armed suspect. We're taking him down.
Hey, Dolores.
And just what is that supposed to mean?
Nothing, dear. I'm sure they're all very grateful you've been doing your part to support the war effort. Are you insinuating something?
Excuse me, ma'am. Do you know where Joe Barbaro lives?
To the right of the stairs. And tell him that racket last night has to stop. If he don't like it, he can find another place to live.
Come on in, let's talk.
You disgusting pig.
I picked up these broads on my way back from the store. I've been waiting for you. All right, girls, that's it for now. I got business. Stop by tomorrow, okay? We'll pick up where we left off. Chop, chop.
Come on, Joey. Why do we have to stop when we can all have fun?
The fun's over, baby. Later, I said. Me and Vito here haven't seen each other for a long time. We got a lot of catching up to do.
Looks like you're doing okay, Joey boy.
Not bad. I tell you, that little Spanish broad is fucking wild. So how'd it go at home?
Good. Mama wasn't thrilled when I mentioned your name, though. You know how she is. She wants me to get a straight job.
You're gonna look for one?
I don't know, but I sure as hell ain't gonna make the same mistake my old man did. I gotta pay off his debts, then get back on my feet and get my own place. I need to make some real money, and punching the clock ain't gonna cut it.
Hey, you can stay with me as long as you need to, and we'll find you a job where you can make good money without killing yourself, all right?
Music to my ears. Right now, I'm living off the 20 bucks the state gives me every week.
I know lots of people who pay well for a risky job, so to speak. I'm sure I can line something up for my oldest friend. The working man's a sucker, that's for damn sure.
You said it.
Okay, step one. I gotta introduce you to Giuseppe so we can pick up them discharge papers. Let's go.
You made enough cash for all this in the last 3 years?
More like the last 3 months. I barely had time to furnish the place.
3 months? Holy shit.
You just gotta know the right people, and you're all set, because you know me. So you thought about what you're gonna do now?
You said you were gonna introduce me to that guy Giuseppe.
No. I meant, you know, the big picture. When you was over there, didn't you think about what you was gonna do when you got back?
Hey, you think I could,
What? Drive, Vito? The roads are icy. You ain't never drove a car before.
Joe, I was driving almost the whole time I was over there.
Yeah, but this ain't no tank, Vito. This is one of the nicest cars money can buy.
I didn't drive a tank. I drove a Jeep.
What the hell's a Jeep?
It's, never mind. You gonna let me drive or what?
All right. Here's the keys. Just be fucking careful. All right, when it's cold as fuck outside, you gotta give it a little more gas than usual. That's the pedal over there on the right.
I know, Joe, I know.
Okay, now make a right here. Then just go straight for a while.
Gotta go away.
But baby, it's cold outside.
This evening has been
hoping that you drop in.
So very nice.
I'll hold your hand. They're just like
my
ice.
My mother will start to worry.
Beautiful, what's your
my
hurry?
My father will be pacing the floor.
Listen to the fireplace
now,
roar.
Really, I've got to scurry.
Beautiful, please don't.
Well, maybe just a half a drink or
so. While I pull.
Hey, what? Hey, Vito, you know what time it is?
It's daytime. How the fuck should I know?
It's time for you to get in your own fucking car.
Yeah, I'd love to if I could afford one.
Who says you're gonna pay for it?
I'll take your hat. Your hair looks swell.
I ought to say no.
Mind am I moving closer?
At least I'm gonna say that I tried.
What's the sense of hurting my pride?
I really can't stay.
Baby, don't hold out.
Oh,
baby,
it's cold outside.
sure you wasn't kidding. They really taught you to drive over there. At least something good come out of it.
Baby, it's cold outside.
The answer is
but
no.
Baby, it's cold outside.
The welcome has
How
been
lucky that you dropped
so
in.
So nice and warm.
Look out the window at that storm.
I sense the room.
Gosh, your lips look.
Ooh, get a load of that baby.
Nice, that's a 42 Jefferson.
Beautiful car like that, it'd be a shame to smash the window. You should grab yourself some lockpicks over at Giuseppe's. Welcome to Giuseppe's General Store, a thief's paradise. You name it, he's got it. He even sells phony gun permits and discharge papers for guys tired of getting their asses shot off. Hey, Giuseppe, I brought
Hello,
you a
Joe.
New customer.
He's straight up, right?
Yes, sir, all the way. This here's Vito, my oldest friend. This is Giuseppe, the best safecracker in Empire
Retired,
Bay.
Retired, please. How are you? The papers for you?
Yeah, they are. You got them finished already?
It was a pain in the ass, but sure, they're done.
Well, thanks. This really gonna work?
Nobody from the army will bother you again, trust me.
You see? What'd I tell you? Here's the money. Take your papers, Vito.
We need a set of lockpicks, too.
That we do. And guess who's paying for them?
Grazie. But you can test it right now. Here. Take this lock. You just need to insert the pick into the lock and lift all the pins. You use the wrench to hold the pins one by one. When all of the pins are set, just turn the wrench and the lock, she opens. Easy.
Ah,
damn it.
See you around, Giuseppe. Se benedig.
Easy, huh?
Don't worry, you'll get the hang of it. I do it all the time when I lock my keys in the car.
Ci vediamo, Vito.
Okay, you still feel like snagging that car?
You kidding me? Absolutely.
Well, here's your chance.
Suspect is about 6 feet tall, dark hair, medium build.
Oh,
Roger that. Yeah, well, it's not over yet. Lose him, quick.
Give it up. The monkey ball right in the air. Monkey ball thought everything was on the square.
Buzzard tried to throw the monkey off of his back, but the monkey grabbed his neck and said, "Now listen, Jack. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. Ain't no use in diving. What's the use
All right. Looks like we lost it. So how do you like the car?
Not too bad. Think I'll keep it.
All right, let's go find ourselves a body shop. They provide the kind of services we're looking for.
Hey, that don't sound cheap.
Don't worry about it. I got it covered. Just find any body shop. I know the guy who runs it.
Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and stay right. Straighten up and fly right.
Park right here in front of the garage door. Okay, now honk your horn.
Well, afternoon to you. What can I do you for, pal? License plate. For you, no problem.
Then I will set you free. The monkey looked the buzzard right dead in the eye and said, "Your story's so touching, it sounds just like a lie. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and stay right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and stay right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your
time. Press Radio News. I'm Lowell Harris. The Soviets have attacked and captured the city of Elbing, Germany. In what has been a brutal and bitterly cold winter, the Soviet forces have taken the German city of Elbing. Losses were heavy for both sides, and the unbearable cold weather certainly couldn't have made things any easier. But somehow, the Soviet forces prevailed. Encouraging news for Allied forces who have had their fill of the brutal winter conditions. Pretty soon it'll be Berlin or bust for the Ruskies. For Press Radio News, I'm Lowell Harris.
There you go. Gave her a couple of tweaks. Are you looking for a new set of wheels? Take your pick, Val. Bring it by anytime.
All right, next you should introduce yourself to Mike Bruski. He'll probably have some work for you.
All right, where is he?
He owns a junkyard over in Riverside. You can't miss him.